Hi everyone, I hope you are fine. Welcome in this video 2.2 about how to start historical sewing. We are going to talk about useful material or not. As my presentation was far too long, I decided to cut it in 3 videos. That's why last time I was talking about the mandatory material, all the stuff you really need to have in order to start historical costumes. You will find a link to this video under this one, it will be in the description. But today I'm going to talk about the quite useful material. I mean all the material that is not mandatory but that will help you to save a lot of time, energy and maybe money. So in my opinion, if you can afford to buy it, I think you should do it. And on part 3 I am going to talk about the not so useful material. All the things that are, to my opinion, just a waste of time. And next time I am going to talk about how to choose expensive material because it has to last as long as possible in order to save you money, and it has to fit exactly to your needs. So you will see that it's quite a difficult topic we are going to talk in the next video. Let's start with a quite useful material. It's not mandatory to have it, but it helps a lot. As you are going to see, some of them cost a lot of money, they are very expensive, and some of them take a lot of space because it's large, big items. So if you cannot store them at home, maybe it's time to ask yourself if you really need to buy it. The sewing machine was invented in the mid 19th century, so if you are reenacting a period before the invention of the sewing machine, and if you want to be 100% accurate, then maybe you should not use one. But to be honest, most of the reenactors are using one just to put the pieces of the costumes together. If the stitches are not seen, then they are using sewing machine for most of them. And they are just finishing the costumes with hand stitching because this stitching will be seen, and they are using the machine just for all of them, which will not be seen by anyone. So it's a good tool, and if you can afford one, maybe it's something you should buy. But it's very, very important to choose it very wisely because it costs a lot of money and it takes a lot of space. So that's why I'm going to talk about it a lot in my next video. Another very, very useful material, it's the mannequin. In fact, if you ask me to choose between mannequin and sewing machine, I must admit that I would choose the mannequin. It's very, very helpful to have one because you will see how the costume is when worn by someone, and it helps you a lot when you are creating the costume itself. So it's very, very important to choose it very wisely too, because it costs a lot of money, and if you don't choose the right mannequin, then it will last a few months and you will waste a lot of money, and it's not a good thing. That's why I will talk about it in my next video too. If you have a mannequin and if you start sewing, then you should pimp your mannequin. First, you just need to add some ribbons. You just need to pin them on the mannequin just to show which are the important lines of the costumes. For example, here you have the waistline that is very, very clear, and it will allow you to go quicker with your costume, and just to fix it when if there is something that goes wrong with your costume, you will see it very, very quickly. By the way, another thing to do is the arm, because in fact you will find a lot of tutorials on the internet to make one or two arms to your mannequin, and it's very, very useful because the shape of your costume will not be the same if your mannequin has some arms. And you have arms, well, I think, so if you have some, please add arms to your mannequin. It will help you a lot for the future. The hot glue gun is very, very useful too. Of course, it's not historically accurate. Of course, it depends on the period you are working on. So I would advise you not to buy one as a start. But if one day you need to make costumes or small accessories, then it's something very, very useful. And you can use it on parts that will not be seen. So in fact, your costume can still be accurate even if you use one of them. So it's something that costs not a lot of money and it can be very useful, so I must admit that I have one and I use it a lot. This little tool is very very interesting because it's a seam ripper, it costs almost nothing, and if one day you make a mistake, and it will happen to you because it happens to anyone, then the seam ripper is going to undo all the stitches you just done. So it's very very useful, but it can be very dangerous because in fact you need to take the fabric and to give some space to the stitches before using the seam ripper, because otherwise it can cut the fabric as well and it can ruin a costume. So be very careful if you use one. And you, as you can see, there is a small ball on the seam ripper. It needs to be under the stitches and not on the upper side, and it's very very important. Of course, if you don't want to use a seam ripper, you can use small scissors. It does the work, it does the job as well, but it's just that it's not as quick as a seam ripper can be. If one day you need to make a corset, then I would advise you to buy a clamp to cut the metal boning, because in fact, when you make corsets, you need metal bonings. Even if it's not on the whole corset, one day you will need to cut this metal boning. So it's something you have to buy, and if you take one that cuts very very easily, then it will be simple for you to make corsets. If one day you try to make some jewels or small accessories, or you need to work on a very precise little thing, I think you should buy a set of small clamps. It costs almost nothing and it's always useful. So as you can see, sometimes sewing is something like crafting. You too can buy pleating foots to add to your sewing machine. It allows you to make pleats very easily and very precisely. It's very useful if you are reenacting 18th or 19th century or the Edwardian period. But before you buy anything like this, be careful, check if your sewing machine is okay with using another foot. And of course, some of the sewing machines can already do it by themselves. So before buying anything, I would advise you to check at the manual of the sewing machine, and maybe you will discover that there is no need of this kind of stuff. If you are reenacting a period with eyelets, I would advise you to buy a good eyelet plier and good eyelets. The quality of the eyelets is very important. You need some washers behind, otherwise it will scratch your skin and maybe make you bleed, so it's very very important to check the quality of the eyelets. I must admit that I am a big fan of the mark Prim. I tried many other marks, but every time I come back to Prim, even if they are more expensive than the other ones, but the quality is just better. So the eyelets, I always use the Prim ones. You too can buy press if you need to put a lot of eyelets on your costumes. It will make you go quicker, but it's very expensive and it takes a lot of space, so I would advise you to test it if one of your friends have one. Before, test it with your friend before buying it, just to be sure. And of course, it would be better if you can embroider yourself your eyelets. The result will be better and will be much more accurate than putting metal eyelets, of course. But there is techniques just to cover your eyelets. Even if they are in metal, you can cover them with the threads of your costume, and it can give you a very good result. So why not using metallic eyelets? In my last video, I was talking about the pinking scissors. It's a good solution if you make some 18th or 19th century costumes or Edwardian period costumes. You always need something to make the pinking at the edge of some fabrics. So scissors can be a solution, but they don't cut that much, and after few costumes you will see that it's not enough. You need something that works better. There's other techniques, like here you have some tools that can be used for leather, but you can use it as well for fabrics, but it will take you ages just to make a wall costume with this technique because it's very, very slow to use it. So I'd rather advise you to buy a pinking machine. It's not very easy to find because you need to buy it in the USA on some websites. Not easy to find, but so helpful. So if you are doing a lot of periods where the edges of fabrics needs to be with the pinking, then the machine is something you really need to have. The third and last part of my presentation is about the not so useful material. What is it? It's something that you see in shops and you say, wow, I need this material so badly, it will help me to make so much costumes. And in fact, once you use it, you finally discover that it's just a gadget to you because you cannot use it because it's not made for historical costumes and stuff like that. So I wanted to talk about it. I think my list is very short. There is many, many more, but here it's what I see as a start. I'll start with the overlock machine because in fact, if you are doing some regular sewing, then why not buying an overlock machine? Because sometimes you are going to use some jersey or knitted fabric, and then the overlock machine will be perfect to edge properly the fabric. But if you are doing some historical costumes, it's a fabric that you will never use, so the overlock machine is absolutely useless. So save your money and don't buy one. The embroidery machine is one of them that is not very useful too, because in fact it's a dream of many people, but it costs a lot of money and it's very, very important to know how to use it properly. Because in fact when you are going to use it for an historical costume, you will need to put a lot of patterns close one by one, and it's very difficult with this kind of machine to make all the patterns to be correct and to be exactly where they should be. So I would advise you before buying one of them, try it properly and be sure that it's exactly what you need. For example, if you want to embroider what is in the frame, sometimes it can take you 20 minutes, and sometimes if the thread is broken by the needle, then you have to start everything anew, and there is a lot of problems with this kind of machines. So be careful before buying it, try it, be sure it's what you need, and be sure that you are going to be able to use it. I know a lot of people who have some and only two of them are able to use it properly. So maybe you will be the third of them, but just to be sure, try it before buying anything, it costs so much. The roulette and the paper, the transfer paper that goes with it, for me seems very useless. Maybe just that I have other techniques and maybe that I don't know how to use them. So if someone can find something to do with this kind of tools, please send me your videos because for sure for me it's a gadget. And I finish with the bias makers. For me, they are just gadget. You can make some bias very easily with an iron, and it's very easy to do. There is no need of these such things. So for me, it's a gadget. Well, I'm sure that I forgot many, many things, and maybe that if you are not a beginner, you are not going to be okay with my categories and what I put in them in the mandatory useful or useless categories. But it's my video, it's my decision, so right now my mindset is like this. Maybe that in 5 or 10 years it will be different, but right now it's like this. It was a video 2.2, it came after two other videos, question to ask yourself before starting, and the mandatory material. The links are below in the description, and that's it for this video. Sorry it took me so long to do it, because I must admit that my English is not very correct, so I have to start again and again and again the slides. So sorry for my bad accent, sorry for my bad English. I do my best, but it's not easy because You know, English is very difficult for French people. To come a big focus on sewing machines and mannequins, it's very important to choose them very wisely. If you do so, it can last all your life and even you can give them to your children. So be take care of what you are buying. Think of the planet. Even if you have the money to buy a lot of sewing machines and mannequins, please choose wisely. It's very, very important. We need to have a more efficient way to do our hobbies. To come, there's other videos, a lot of other videos. The supplies, the techniques, which kind of events, the world of costume people, and the history of costumes. Till there, take care and bye bye, and thank you very much for following me. Bye bye.